We've seen how to create trend tags that store data in the system. We can then view the trend charts directly or compile the data into basic reports. However, we have another option for historical data analysis. If more complex tools are needed, the Advanced Reports and Dashboards module may suit your needs. Before we get into its integration, though, let's review our system's architecture. We've been developing a project directly on our server machine. Of course, we could also view the Web Hmi remotely from a client machine, tablet, or even a phone on the network. You'll recall that we could also have a redundant server available, but that doesn't change our project integration significantly. Advanced Reports adds a new component to this architecture. This software requires an additional license and is usually installed on its own server. However, as long as you can meet the requirements, it may be run on the same hardware, as I have here. As for the Advanced Reports configuration itself, there are two options for populating the database. You may multi-master the devices in your network by adding them to the Advanced Reports Management Console tool, which I have done here. You can find more information on this process elsewhere under the name of the full software package, Power Monitoring Expert. For that matter, if you already have the full PME installed and configured, it can be integrated into the Web Hmi just like Advanced Reports and Dashboards. There are only minor branding and licensing differences between the two. The other method for integrating Advanced Reports uses a tool called the ETL, which stands for Extract, Transform, Load. This tool extracts data from our trend files, optionally performs some alignment transformations, and loads the data in the Advanced Reports SQL database. There are a number of pros and cons to this method, and we will discuss this in a later video. Once Advanced Reports has been configured, we can integrate it into the Web Hmi. When complete, we will have one or more tabs at the top of the page that will automatically sign us into the AR server and forward its web applications pages directly into the Web Hmi. You shouldn't even see that there are two applications running. You'll want to open up the system guide to add advanced dashboards and reports into web applications, because there are some useful code blocks to copy and paste. Once the integration is done, we will run through the basics of building dashboards and running reports. Again, if you need more information, please look up Power Monitoring Expert. If your Advanced Reports server is ready, let's get started. Until then, thank you.